The tested respirators could filter down to 0.007 microns. And that is of course much smaller than the Serrasus sickness. Check this out, this is a size comparison. Compared to a red blood cell, a bacteria, it's so tiny. But as I just said, the 0.007 micrometers, oh my goodness, it's so small. That's definitely good news.
Initiating. Welcome back to my daily grind. Create yourself is what you'll find me doing every day and every night. No time to lose, one day, one step in the right direction. I'm Chris and I'm only here to show you if I can do it, you can do it too.
Welcome back to the vlog. It is Saturday, another day, another chance to push hard. And the topic for this vlog is, can a respirator actually filter a virus? So let's get it. By the way, all the DIY projects right here. Yeah, I know, it's like kind of weird, but just watch them all. But before we get started, love goes out to all my subscribers. Thank you for making my life special and worth living to the max. So let me try to give back with a sweet, sweet video. Now in my last vlog, I got highly excited. Check it out right here. I talked about a visualization experiment from a research group that showed the particles that are left behind after a sneeze in the air. Oh my God, it's so crazy. So all of this was a ramp up to this vlog. So there are particles left in the air, tiny particles, because the big ones, they fall on the ground. Only the tiny ones are left floating, and it looks like that there are many of them, with viruses of course embedded in these particles. Now, is it even possible to filter it out with a respirator? Is this even possible? So let's get to this question. By the way, the source for this will be linked in the description. Check it out if you want to know more, read up and stuff. But now let's get right to it. Okay, first of all, how big is it? How big is this virus? So the Serrasus virus is 0.062.14 microns in diameter, compared to the flu, 0.08 to 0.12. So the Serrasus sickness has more variants, you could say. Let's get to the respirators. Respirators with a high efficiency at 0.3 micron particle size. Wait a second, this is way bigger. How is this possible? Well, they can filter particles down to the size of the Serrasus sickness, which is around 0.1 microns. But as I said in my ratings comparison vlog, you can check it out right here, these respirators aren't an absolute barrier. They are merely, well, they have a rejection rate. So they have the potential to actually filter them out, but also there is more research required to get specific data about the current situation. The size was established in a recent paper. You can find the link on the linked page. The size that I was talking about was established in a recent paper and they used electron microscopy. The variation of the diameter leads back to these spikes. They will also give it various appearances. But let's get back to the actual question. As I already said, the Serrasus sickness, the virus, is smaller than 0.3. What does it mean? The ratings, they focus on a specific particle size. That won't mean that it's not filtering small particles. It's basically like speakers, actually. They have this frequency curve. And for example, my speakers, they play from 40 hertz all the way up to 20 kilohertz. But they actually can play even lower. They can even play 20 kilohertz, but it's just getting, the volume is just getting lower and lower and lower. It's the same, they can filter smaller particles too, but it will just, the efficiency will decrease basically. To be specific, check this out. The reason for the focus on 0.3 microns is because it is the most penetrating particle size, MPPS. Particles above this size move in ways we might anticipate, and they will also get trapped in the filter with gaps smaller than the particle size. Of course, well, duh, okay, right. Particles smaller than that exhibit what is called Brownian motion, which makes them easier to filter. Wait a second, what? Brownian motion refers to a phenomenon whereby the particle's mass is small enough that it no longer travels unimpeded through the air. Dude, what? Instead, it interacts with the molecules in the air, causing it to pinball between them, moving in an erratic pattern. According to researchers, this point between normal motion and Brownian motion is the hardest particle size for filters to capture. Oh, that's interesting. So really small ones will move randomly erratic, and bigger ones will move predictably, basically. But there is a tipping point where it's unpredictable, basically. Okay, to conclude, what we can take away from this is that higher filter efficiency at 0.3 micron size will generally translate to higher filter efficiency below the size as well. Okay, let's get deeper into this, because why not? Here's a picture of Brownian motion. It's not moving linear, it's like bouncing around, it's crazy. Let's look at more specific research. In this article by 3M, we can see that N95 respirators are actually able to filter 0.1 micron size particles with 94% efficiency or higher. This is pretty much the same as the rating says. Amazing. There is another article from smartfilters.com showing that the tested respirators could filter down to 0.007 microns. And that is of course much smaller than the cervical sickness. What? An FFP1 rated was able to filter 96% of particles down. Oh my god. And this will suggest of course that FFP2 and FFP3 will achieve even greater results. My goodness. Check this out. This is a size comparison. What is that? Compared to a red blood cell, a bacteria, it's so tiny. So this thing is already tiny, but as I just said, the 0.007 micrometers, oh my goodness, it's so small. That's definitely good news. Also remember, mostly it's dispensed in particles in the air, well, in saliva particles or something like that. So it's even bigger then. Let's go. So to conclude, yes, it is possible that respirators filter even viry from the air, out of the air. But again, it's not a shield, it's not a perfect shield, it's not an absolute barrier, it's rated. It has a rejection rate. So yes, it does work. Wow, who would have expected that? Respirators do work, they do filter a virus. Amazing knowledge. Let's use them. Also, there will be another vlog, this one right here, further investigating these snap-on filters because they have even more ratings, like oil resistance and, you know, there is a lot to them. So this might be another interesting topic to look into because, as I said, upgrading from disposable respirators to actual half-mask filters is awesome. The seal is amazing. I can just recommend it. But yeah, that's it for this one. Smash that like button. The way I'm sure that the cervical sickness wants to smash freaking respirators for filtering it. Bang the bell like clap, pop, to never miss DIY projects. And check the recent news on chrisviral.com. And yeah, that's it for today. I will see you tomorrow.